Guys, welcome back to Coden. So guys, I hope you all are taking care of yourself, enjoying the videos that I'm posting for you, and loving the content what I'm posting, the short videos and well as these videos. Do let me know in the comment section what else you want, and I'm going to try to post that also. In today's lesson, I'm going to talk about traversal and singly linked list. I've already explained you about insertion, deletion, and the other operation that we perform on an array. And this video is just based upon linked list. Soon I'm going to try to make a video on the new subject, maybe computer structures or maybe DBMS. So guys, if you like the content that I post, please do like it, share and subscribe to my channel. Already on my YouTube channel, I posted content regarding C, C++, Python, HTML, Java, CSS, summary videos before your exam, and also some important Excel tips which are in my shorts videos. If you want the full playlist of every video, just go to the playlist section and you can fetch any type of videos from there. And also do let me know in the comment section what other content that you need, and please help me reach more subscribers. So guys, if you like the content, please do like it, share, subscribe to my channel. So let's get started with this video without wasting any time. Coming to the very first thing that we talked about, we are going to learn about traversal. So whenever I'm talking about traversal, what do we mean by traversal? We have performed insertion, we have performed deletion. Now there is an operation in which I want to go to each and every node of the linked list and want to check that what is present in that desired linked list. For that, what we use a traversal operation. So now, what is the basic algorithm while using a traversal operation? As you can see on the screen, we have to traverse a linked list. So as you always know that we have a start pointer, and then we again link that pointer accordingly. So for that, first of all we will set the PTR as start, means we'll make the pointer start at first location. Then what we are going to do, we are going to repeat some steps 3 to 4 unless and until the PTR is not equal to null. Means as soon as the value will be equal to null, it will get exit. Unless it not equals to null, it will keep on repeating. It will keep on telling that whatever the info is present in the desired linked list. So here we have repeat the step 3 to 4. Then I have to apply the process that info PTR, that whatever info is present in PTR, it will store that in the PTR pointer and which link to the next pointer. So accordingly, this whole loop will keep on working again and again. And as soon as it will be equals to null, it will exit from the program. So now let us understand this program with the help of an example, which will make you more clear that how we need to run the code and what is the exactly program of this algorithm. With the help of a desired program, and what do we mean by traversal and how does this actually work? So first of all, I'm including the necessary header file that I want to include. Then I've started with the struct node in which I'm going to add int info. Then I've taken node next, star next, start, rare, and whatever pointers that I want to use in the program. So I've taken these pointers as an object in the structure. So if you're not clear that how do we define structure, do watch my previous videos. I've already explained you about how do we do insertion, how do we deletion, and other things that we do in an array. And if you are not clear about some of the header files, you can also check my previous videos. So I try to make each and everything clear so that it's easy for you to understand and make the program fully clear that what exactly is working in the program. So first of all, what I'm creating over here, first of all, I'm creating a node star create new node list. Basically, this function is taking one integer argument and allocates the memory to create a new node and returns the pointer to the new node. So basically, we are going to perform that only. PTR equals to new node, PTR I info, which is pointing to the next list, is equals to n, is storing in n. Then it is making to the next linked list. If it is equals to null, it is keep on adding the info unless it is equals to null, then it will return that pointer. So for that, I have taken return PTR, whichever pointer I want to declare. So I have already explained you about that, how we are creating a new node, how I am performing insertion. These things I have repeated again and again in every video in which I have told you about linked list, in which I have told you about that how we perform insertion and how we perform deletion. Now why I'm using over here insert function, because whenever I want to perform traversal, I basically mean want to check each and every element one by one. So for that, I first of all need to insert some element. For that, I've taken over here a void insert function. Basically, what is this function doing? Takes node star type pointer as argument and inserts this node in the end of the list. So basically what it is doing, it is inserting a node into the end of the list. So how it will add? If start equals to null, start equals to rare equals to np, else rare will point to next and it will stored in np, or rare will be, and then rare will be equals to np. These will be the two condition. Means if it is already null, then only it will add the value. If it is not null, then what it will do, it will move to the next pointer. So now coming to the very main part that we are going to perform in this. So now when you will see this function, traverse function, you will be able to understand that what it is doing exactly that it was doing in the algorithm. So basically this function is to take node start type pointer as an argument and display the list from this pointer in the end of the list. So here you can see while np is not equals to null, like we were doing in the algorithm, that unless it equals to null, it will keep on checking. So then I have taken a cout statement in which I am going to do cout np info. Basically I am going to print that info that is present into that desired linked list. Now as soon as the first info is been printed, now I am going to point to the next, unless is until is not equals to null, so I have pointed to the next. So this step will keep on repeating unless it, the values are at the end that is null. Means as soon as we will encounter null, it will stop and not display that desired value. So now what we have to do in the main function. So coming to the main function, I have already explained you that in the previous videos also what we are doing exactly in the main function. But to make you more clear who is watching the video for the first time, so I am making you understand each and every step that I am performing over here, so that it easy for the first time viewer also to understand everything. So guys, if you like the effort that I am putting for you, please do give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel so that you get regular notification of whatever I post for you. So I have already posted things regarding some tips also, and also other content. So do support it and share it as much as possible, and do subscribe to my channel. So here I have taken for the linked list start equals to rare equals to null. Then I have taken an int inf. Basically the int inf over here is to enter the data into the linked list. So for entering the data into the linked list, I have taken here as int inf. Then I have taken a character ch equals to y, which is basically for either I want to enter more or do not want to enter more, with the help of a while loop. So I have taken two things, the lower letter y and the upper case also y. So for taking the information, I have taken the variable inf. Now I want to use a new pointer in which I have taken create new node, and then I'm going to pass that integer. So what it will do, it will call that desired function new node and will get the value from the user. Now if the new pointer is equals to null, then it will say that cannot be printed, means cannot create a new node. This I have already told you in the previous videos that why it cannot create a new node. Do check that out also, and if you are clear with that, do let me know in the comment section that my videos are making you clear everything easily. Now I have used over here exit function. Basically the exit function is under the header file process.h. Why I could suggest you to learn this way, because it will make you more clear that how the concepts are actually working and how you can perform each and everything. What is the actual every header file doing? So that is the reason I am explaining you each of this in this compiler, and also easy to execute for you. Now I am going to give a statement that if I want to enter more, I need to press Y. If I do not want to enter more nodes, I will press N. It is your choice, either you press N or any of the character, it will automatically get exit from the program. I will show you in the output case when we are going to run the output. Now I am going to write the cout statement. I am going to just print the list. So basically printing of the list means we are going to perform the traversal. Means it will show us all the list. So I am going to use the list now here is with the help of the traverse function. In the traverse function, what I am going to pass? I am going to pass the start pointer. So we know that in the traverse function, what we have to pass? We have to pass this pointer. So I have taken over here as traverse start. So when I am going to run this code, what is the output that is going to show to me? That it is going to run the code and ask me that enter information to the node. First of all, I have entered information. If you want to enter more, enter yes. Keep on adding the information unless you want to enter the information, like I have done over here. As soon as you do not want, just press N, or that the list will be displayed to you. So guys, if you like the content that I post, please do like it, share, subscribe to my channel. I hope you must be clear about what do I mean by traversal. Do let me know in the comment section what is the algorithm for traversal, if you are clear with the video. And do not watch it the back, just try to implement that, and do let me know in the comments. So guys, if you like the content that I post, please do like it, share, subscribe to my channel, and also you can follow me on my Instagram page. Please do like it, share, subscribe to my channel, and show some support. Thank you so much for watching. Keep smiling.